children, but it can also be dangerous if you're not careful. Before your little ghosts and goblins go out trick-or-treating, make sure they stay safe. This morning, Randleman Police Chief Richard Weinblatt joins us with some good information, some good tips. Good morning.
Good morning.
Thanks so much for coming in this morning.
Yeah, thanks for having us.
First of all, let's talk about the actual costume itself, because mm-hmm. it can cause problems.
That's right. We want makeup. We'd rather not have them have masks, because masks restrict their vision, their peripheral vision.
Right.
They're not going to be able to see cars coming. We'd rather have them use makeups and maybe some crazy hats or things like that. So that would be a better thing for them to use.
Yeah, because I trying masks on, you can really tell. I mean, if you're going to get your kid a mask, make sure you try it on to see if you can see out of it.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And that's good advice.
What about trick-or-treating itself?
Well, I think we have to realize that times have changed, mm-hmm. unfortunately. And if you are going to have your kids go out, and a lot of churches and other groups are having private parties, which mm-hmm. is a good thing for parents to consider. But if you are going to, younger children have no business going out by themselves. You should go with them and kind of make it a fun activity that they're doing together anyway. It's kind of a bonding time.
Yeah. When we go from house to house, one of the problems is you don't want to walk in the road where cars are.
That's correct. They should keep an eye on traffic, and they should walk on the sidewalk. How many times have you ridden along in Halloween and you see children just darting across the street? They really should walk on the sidewalk. And of course, if they're going to be out there and it's darker, they really should wear light-colored or reflective clothing. They could put reflective tape on themselves, as well as if they're on a bike or riding a broom, they could put reflective tape on their broom.
And that's a great idea, because a lot of times kids will dress up and they'll wear like a dark costume if they're a witch or a ninja or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
They do have now out, which I think is a neat little idea. They've got these little pens and stuff that you can put on that has like a little blinker in it. You can
mm-hmm.
hit the button and it'll
mm-hmm.
blink. So
sure.
at least that's something to show motorists
sure.
that the kids are out there.
And then on top of that, they can carry a flashlight.
Yeah.
They can carry a glow stick. And those glow sticks will be on for anywhere from 4 to 6 to 8 hours, depending which ones you get.
And kids love that.
Oh, yeah, and they're fun to play with.
Yeah. What about houses that you go to?
Definitely want to pick homes that have a lighted porch. You want to go to a place that's inviting. And, of course, you never want to go into that house, especially if it's a stranger. You just don't want to go into that house because, we want this to be a fun and scary event, but not a tragic event.
Right. And when we come home,
Mom and Dad, who hopefully are with you all along anyway, should inspect the treats, and hopefully folks are giving them healthy types of treats,
right.
And then the parents are going to portion that out so that it doesn't all get eaten the next morning, and then
yeah.
you get sick, and that's not good either.
Yeah. Well, Chief Weinblatt, thanks so much for joining us this morning. Some good advice that I hope folks at home will definitely follow.
Well, thank you, and happy Halloween to everybody.